Southern Ontario. I come from the black community for many years, concurrently for artists and entertainers and cultural entrepreneurs fill the provincial coffers with taxes generated from festivals like, can I still call it Tarabana? Afrofest, Jamaica Day, Jambana, Jerk Fest, Rasta Fest, and many others. And we started a coalition to actually make a case about what we're working on. Band, the OBHS, and Buxton Museum in Chatham, where I spent a lot of my time when I was at the University of Windsor, continues to provide significant education and edutainment, we call it, experiences for Ontarians to learn about black culture. If elected, what will you do to make the museum not just a dream, but a reality? More urgently, what plan do you have for sustained funding and promotion of black arts and culture to the benefit of Ontarians for the 1.4 million people, visitors we bring into this province every year?
You have to get organized. Right, yeah, 10 different voices.
So that was both an excellent question and an amazing advertisement at the same time. So absolutely we need more funding to the Ontario Arts Council and directed to specifically to minority communities, absolutely. And the bottom line is, and I can say this as a longtime small business owner, the economic benefits for our local businesses of cultural activities is huge. And so financial support for those activities not only benefits the communities whose culture we're celebrating, but it also benefits those communities economically, and therefore those communities should receive funding to provide those benefits. And absolutely, I'm with you 100% on fighting for the museum.
So, two parts to your question. In terms of the sustained arts funding, we have just increased the Ontario Arts Council by $50 million over the next few years, and part of that money is targeted at racialized communities. So black arts is part of the mandate for investing that money. I love the idea of the museum. I think that's a great idea. I'll be honest with you, I haven't seen a proposal. I don't know. You said the coalition is coming together, so if I'm back in this chair, I absolutely would like to see what the proposal looks like. I think it's a great idea.
Thanks, Denise, for the question. It's an important one. And I think that we have to always remember that commitment to arts and culture needs to be starting in the schools and carried on throughout the community. So that's a big commitment that we have. But look, the other thing that we need to talk about is not just the Ontario Arts Council or the Ontario Media Development Corporation. What do those organizations look like? Who are on the boards of those organizations? Do they reflect the community? Is there a mandate for equity? Is there a commitment that every year of granting dollars, there needs to be an equity lens put on those grants? These are the kinds of systemic changes that we need to look at. And when it comes to the museum, long past due. The museum was built a long time ago. It should be up and running now everywhere, for sure.
So, we're going to turn some of these questions.